Hello friends, welcome to the Shrakshit channel. If you are watching my channel for the first time, click subscribe button and hit the notification bell so you won't miss any of my videos. In today's video, here I am going to share a morning breakfast routine vlog. For today's breakfast, here I prepared the tangy mango rice. First, take out all the required ingredients required for the mango rice. And first, here I'm going to cook the rice in a pressure cooker. So here I've taken 1 glass of rice, wash it thoroughly for 2 to 3 times, and pressure it under 3 vessels on a medium flame. Take out all the ingredients from the fridge at a time, so there will be no tense while cooking. So if you are in hurry burry, for 1 glass of rice add 2.5 glass of water and cook on a high flame for 4 whistles and open the pressure immediately, so your rice will be ready. In meanwhile, I am going to chop all the veggies required for the mango rice. Here I have taken 1 medium sized onion and 1 medium sized mango, some curry leaves, coriander and 2 green chilies. You can increase or decrease the quantity of green chilies according to your taste. Chop onion into fine pieces and grate the mango in smaller one. While grating, deseed the mango in this way. On the other hand, I am preparing the tea. Here I am today preparing the ginger tea. If you want, you can even add the fresh ginger. Here I am adding the ginger powder. Always store the ginger powder in a glass container so that its flavor retains. So here my tea is ready. I am going to enjoy and then I am going to start my cooking. Once the pressure is released, transfer the rice into an open plate and allow it to cool so that it becomes a grainy while mixing in the mango rice, otherwise it becomes mushy consistency. Follow this tip if you want a grainy rice. On the other hand, I am boiling the milk. Always we used to buy the milk from the farmer directly, so that there will be a lot of dust particles in the milk. If you are buying direct from the farmer, filter it before pouring into the vessel and boil at least for 25 to 30 minutes, because the milk we are buying from the farmer are unpasteurized milk, so the bacteria always remains in the milk unkilled. So boil at least for 20 to 25 minutes. On the other hand, I kept the kadai and first I am going to dry roast the peanuts. This is an additionally optional step. If you want, you can even add directly into the oil. Once peanuts are roasted, transfer them into a plate and add 2 spoons of oil and add 1 spoon of mustard, 1 spoon of cumin, 1 spoon of urad dal, 1 spoon of chana dal and roasted peanuts. Sauté it well on a medium flame and add 2 sprigs of curry leaves and 2 slit green chilies and chopped onion. Sauté it well until onion becomes transparent. If you want, you can even add the cashews. Here I have added 5 to 6 cashew nuts. Add the required quantity of salt required for the whole recipe. Add 1/4 spoon of turmeric. If you want more tanginess, here you can even add 1 lemon. Add the grated mango and let it cook for 5 to 8 minutes on a low flame. So here I have cooled rice and add the rice into the kadai and mix it well. Add chopped coriander And here our tangy mango rice is ready. Still the milk is boiling. The milk we get from the shops in the packets or pasteurized milk, so we no need to boil the packet milks for 20 to 30 minutes. For cow milk, which we are directly getting from the farmer, should be boiled for at least 25 minutes. In the meanwhile, I'm going to wash the vessels. Always a clean sink without vessels gives a very enthusiasm for cooking. Once you finished washing all the vessels, clean the countertop and my milk is still boiling and my breakfast is also ready. A yummy tangy mango rice. Hope you like the video. Thanks for watching. Have a happy day. If you like, give big thumbs up and leave your comments in comment section. Don't forget to subscribe.